Okay, I feel like I should start off with people I generally know too. Dude, this is so hard. Cause like, what do we calculate it by? Like, what gives a villain a good ranking? I feel like we should set that precedent first. Cause I could like one villain for them being like super cool, but then also they could be like lame in terms of writing. Maybe I should try and go in order to not skip people. We'll start with Kabuto. I feel like that's a good one to start on. So Kabuto's a really enjoyment over writing. Kabuto's like a really old one. Of course, he was like in the show for a long time, which is weird to think about. He was straight up there at Naruto and all them's tunings, you know? Enjoyment in terms of writing. I'm glad he got an episode where it showed his whole backstory and how it's kind of like he had a low-key depressing backstory with the glasses and everything. But I feel like he kind of fell off at the end of the war arc, you know? Like, it was, like, supposed to be this chess game, you know? He's controlling all the pieces. And then it was just, like, I don't know. He had a cool design, too. And he was also under Orochimaru. He'll definitely be under, like, ranked under Orochimaru for me. I think Orochimaru's just a more sly villain. I'll put him at C. He would be lower if he was like a newer character, but he's like so overarching that gives him points, if that makes sense. So it's only appropriate to do Orochimaru next. I feel like Orochimaru is super overarching too. I don't know why I'm just saying Kabuto, but I guess he was also, you know, dead for a hot minute there. But is he ever really dead? Is Orochimaru ever really dead? I'm leaning between S and A. The reason why I'm leaning towards S is because like his attack on the leaf, like originally was super like, oh no, OMG, leaf under attack, Orochimaru, final villain. Oh. He's just so creepy. And I love him in Boruto. Like every scene he's in Boruto now, it's like, I don't know, he's captivating. He gave the world Mitsuki, dude. He gave the world Mitsuki. I'm gonna start by putting him in S. For now. I might change it later. I know chat's saying A, but I'm gonna put him in S for now. I know this is a guy from the Sound 4, but I'm gonna keep it a buck. I do not remember. Wait, no. That's not Sound 4. I'm so sorry. That's the very first guy. Episode 1. That's rebelling. Yeah. Oh, man. That's literally episode 1. What were his intentions again? He just hated the Hokage, right? And he was the one that originally told Naruto who he was. He wanted to kill Naruto? I thought he wanted Naruto to like go crazy. Yeah, he almost killed Iruka, yeah. So he started everything. That's kind of like weird though, putting him in like a tier list. I guess he is a villain. I'll put him in D. I would put him in F, but he was in episode 1, dude. He started everything. No, I feel like he deserves C. Cause that scene where he forced Aruka's speech about like how he still cares for Naruto, you know? I don't know, that was like the beginning of like Naruto's turning point, even though it was episode 1, but you know what I mean. Gaara is a little weird. Do I rank him on being a villain or a character? Cause this is a villain tier list. And he wasn't a great villain. He's a good character, but he didn't do much villainous things. Does that make sense? That's weird that he's in it. I'm gonna come back to Gaara. That's weird. Itachi's weird because he's not really even a villain. Well, he is a villain, but you know what I mean. But Itachi's like the most overarching storyline because, like, you know, the original Uchiha like massacre. He'll go in S. Should I rank it like this? Like, should I even like rank the categories? You know what I mean? He's not much of a villain, but like you think of him as a villain for a majority of the series. Kisame. I like Kisame a lot, dude. He's got a special place in my heart. Mostly just because all the Akatsuki are so serious, you know? They're all just like death. Oh, I mean, I guess Deidara and Hidan aren't insanely serious, but Kisame, like, I feel like you just like have a beer and hang out with Kisame, you know what I'm talking about? I'm leaning between A and B. I'm gonna put Kisame in A solely because of his death, dude. Solely because this man literally ordered his sharks to eat him in order to not give up information because they were gonna, you know, get it from his mind. Literally A, solely because, dude, that is the most BA thing ever. You cannot say that isn't. Oh, Chat, friends, right? I didn't realize it. There's Shippuden, Kabuto, and OG. Oh, okay. I'm gonna put OG Kabuto in B, and then Shippuden, Kabuto in C. I think that's fair because I definitely liked Kabuto a lot more before he became like the chess player. You know what I mean? Sound four. I'm gonna rate these based off what I remember, like those that made the biggest impact, because I don't remember the sound four that well. Big Sucka, as Hasten would probably say. I'm gonna rate him a little bit higher than the others probably because I straight up thought he killed Choji, bro. I straight up thought Choji died. We'll be in D. I'm gonna put him in F, her in F. I kind of want to put, this is one that played the flute, right? I kind of want to put him in D because the flute was a little bit intimidating. Like, it was creepy. You know what I mean? It was a little spooky. Does that make sense? Why'd you put them in F? Because they're not that memorable. Well, I mean, they're memorable, but like, I don't know. They were just kind of, I don't want to call them filler villains, but it felt like filler villains, even though they were the sound four under Kimimaro, you know? I'm actually going to, they're not even F tier though. They're not bad. They're just not as memorable. In fact, I'm gonna move him up one. Okay, I'm gonna adjust it a little bit. I think that's a little bit better. Kimimaro is gonna head straight to A. Kimimaro, I like because he's super, not just the fact that he's nonchalant, but also he gave us the rock, like the drunken fistly versus him. And the fact that this man has the respect to stop while Lee took his quote medicine. You know what I'm saying? This man has honor, you know? I think he deserves A solely for that, honestly. Wait, this is the dude Sasuke. This is the dude that Sasuke broke his arms, right? Why? Chat, tell me what I should know about this guy. That's all I remember about this dude. He was a little creepy going into the tunings and Sasuke broke his arms. That's not him? No! Wait, is this him? Is this him? That's the demon brother? Came from the little puddle before the Zabuza arc. What? Sasuke broke this guy's arms, right? Sasuke broke this guy's arms? I'll put him in D just for that. Going to F. Also F. Dude, I expected more from this guy. This is gonna be tough. Dosu is a solid B rank. I'm gonna put White Zetsu. This is tough. What do you guys think? Black Zetsu B, White Zetsu C? White Zetsu did cause the war though with all the minions. This is true. I'm gonna leave him there for now. I think that's good for right now. So these two are the ones that Kakashi, Obito, and Rin fought, right? I'm pretty sure. This is the one where Obito awakened his Sharingan. And this is the one that Kakashi and Obito fought together. They are forgettable. No, I'm gonna move him back up. I'm gonna put them in D. Sorcery. Sorcery's cool. I honestly was sad that Sorcery was taken out so quickly. High B, he's interesting, but doesn't have much depth to him. That's true too. Datara was very predictable in terms of what he said and what he did. But I really liked his fight against Sasuke a lot, where Sasuke used his sword in the ground as a foothold. I'll give Sorcery B. Not A. He didn't live long enough to be A, but he's still really cool. The 100 puppets, man. I would put him above Kabuto and Black Zetsu too. I know I said I wasn't really doing that, but I would put him above. I kind of like this. Wait, right, like, wait, right there. I kind of like that. Toby's easy A, dude. Every time he was on screen, I was dying laughing. Okay, so this is Toby, and this is like actually Obito. It's weird that they don't just put Obito. They should have done that. Oh, well, it's fine. Obito, S? I'm pretty sure if I don't put Obito in S, I'll get flamed. You know what's one of my biggest pet peeves? And it's whenever people are like, ha, Obito tried to destroy the world because of a girl. What a simp, dude. I hate that so much. I think his character was a lot more... Yeah, I'm gonna put Obito in S. Overarching, the reveal was Pog. Fight with Kakashi. Sacrifice for Kakashi and Naruto and Sakura and Sasuke. I'm gonna put him above Kimimaro. I'm gonna put him above Itachi as a villain, if that makes sense. I low-key still think Orochimaru is even a better villain though. Hidan! I love Hidan, dude. He was cool. His scythe was really cool. See, I feel like Hidan's also predictable like Deidara, but did I like Hidan or Deidara more? I low-key liked Hidan more. I thought he was a cooler concept because I feel like the clay concept got old fast. Does that make sense? I know he made himself like a giant version at the end too, which was cool. I'm gonna get flamed so hard either way. I'm gonna say he's better than Sasori and Deidara, but not in an A. I'm gonna put him right under Toby, actually. Yeah. Kakuzu, also a cool one. Good fight too. Do I like Hidon or Kakuzu more? I think I like Hidon more just because he's more easygoing. I'll put him right under Hidon. Let's do these two goobers. these two twin goobers, the gold and silver boys. I accidentally put them in F, but I'm actually going to actually put them in F. A, because they should have been a billion times stronger than they made themselves look like. They had nine tails chakra, my guy. And they were... oh my god, actual goobers. What are their names? Ginkaku and Kinkaku, dude. Are those actually the ones that killed Tobirama? I'm slowly developing an addiction for Valorant skins. Help me, please. I would say I could, but I'm addicted to League skins. So, I mean, Riot just has us, you know, iron grip, baby. That's how Riot be. So, let's talk about Sasuke. Let's talk about Sasuke for a bit. I'm gonna put some people in front of the Akatsuki, like I said, since we're doing Akatsuki. Sasuke! Good villain, little too emo. I love Sasuke. He's probably one of my favorite characters in the show, but it got to the point where it was like annoying, you know, listening to him sometimes. The entire history of everything would be explained to Sasuke, and he was just like, I still kind of want to kill people. I'm going to be honest. You know what I'm saying? it was kind of frustrating. Like, he acted like he was smarter than everything. But I guess that was his perception, you know? I would rate him higher as a general character, but we're rating him as a villain, okay? And as a villain, I'm going to put him in A. Tonari. That's a random one. He's still in play in Boruto. I don't even know his purpose. As if you guys aren't aware, like some people, I'm at episode 85? I think I'm at like 85 in Boruto. Tonari's like speaking to Boruto and stuff over the course of the series so far. But of course he premiered in Naruto the Last, the movie. He was kind of a lackluster villain in the movie. I was never worried. Does that make sense? Like, I never felt like they should have been scared of Tonari. It was a kind of cool fight at the end of the Last. Now you also have to take into account like the final battle between Sasuke and Naruto. I would also account into like his villainous status, you know what I mean? Which is my favorite fight in the show. Behind Zetsu, I'll put him there. This is the mob boss guy on the bridge, right? Gato. Yeah, he's a cat, dude. I'll put him in D just because I liked his death. He got absolutely rolled in smoke, dude. Billion just stabbings. And he just fell, didn't he fall off the bridge after too? Haku, where are we putting Haku, chat? My man crush Monday. Haku a baddie? I see nothing wrong with that statement. Haku gets points also for like the closure he got in Shippuden too. I would say better written than Kabuto and White Zetsu. I'll put Haku in B. But Haku's like low-key a better villain than Sasuke. I'm gonna move Sasuke as a villain down to B, honestly. I don't even know what the order of this anymore. This is just such a mess. The ghetto statue. I would say low-key a disappointment, but it was still super dope. Especially whenever you saw like the Ten Tails form. This is weird though, because it's not even like a person. It's like a creature, you know? All the rest of these are like somewhat people, at least. I would put the Ten Tails like top of C, I think. That's Ten Tails, not the ghetto statue. Oh, wait, you're right. No. I'll put it there. I could probably second guess myself on like every one of these decisions, honestly. And if I do upload this to YouTube, I know like 90% of people are gonna skip to the very end without like listening to me, see some of my picks, dislike the video and leave. I guarantee it, guarantee it. Konan. Konan definitely gets points for how many paper bombs was it that she fought against? Konan, number of paper bombs. How many was it? 600 billion? 600 billion. 600 billion paper bombs, dude. I think she automatically gets into B tier for that. That's pretty insane, chat. Come on. But those paper bombs were as a hero, not as a villain. Ah, that's true. Ah, god dang it. That's not fair though. Okay, as a villain, I would rank her lower then. She took down the entire Amazon rainforest to do it. I think she loses points for that one. she didn't do much. I think the full extent of her villainy was fighting Jiraiya at first, when Jiraiya first went to the rain. God dang it, I like Konan too. I'll put her in C. As a villain, if we were counting like her heroic stuff, then I probably would have shot her up. Like maybe like B or A, I don't know. But as a villain, I'll put her in C. Probably right there. She is littering S tier villain. Hanzo of the rain. Hanzo was cool, he had a salamander. His backstory is low-key really depressing. Do you remember his backstory? And then he committed seppuku whenever he was resurrected. Remember how he committed seppuku? Like the samurai gave him his blade? That was low-key a really depressing moment, but really impactful. His death was really good, dude. I'm gonna put him in C. No, B. I think B. I don't know, dude. B's getting pretty crowded. Who is this? I'm gonna keep it a buck. Who is this? They have like a horn. The other guy from the pond. Chat, listen. Okay, am I wrong for putting these two down here? Am I wrong for that? Because like I said, I barely remember the very, 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 very beginning of original Naruto. Am I wrong for that? No? Okay. Pain! I'll put Pain in S right away. As a villain, I think he's a better villain than those. I would say he's close to Orochimaru. I feel like they're very interchangeable. Changeable. Yeah, Pain's an instant S. I don't think that needs to be explained. Just his motivation. I feel like his speech to Naruto too is the most important part. But honestly, I think Haku had a bigger impact on the show. So he's gonna go, I think, right below Haku. I'm pretty sure. I know like 90% of chat knows I'm capping, but I know that like one or two people are just like seething right now. I'll put him up. Yeah, true. He obliterated the Hidden Leaf Village. Donzo! Dude, I think Donzo is the only villain in the show where I was literally getting mad at what he was doing. And I feel like that's a really good villain. As much as I hate Donzo, I feel like that's what makes him an S tier villain. I was literally getting mad at what he was doing. He's not cooler than Kisame. He's not cooler than Sasuke. He's not cooler than Deidara. He's not cooler than Hanzo. But I was legitimately annoyed by what he did. And I feel like that's what ranks you high in a villain tier list. We're gonna do Madara in a little bit. I know a lot of people. We'll just get it out of the way. Chat, listen. Listen, chat. He's so BA, man. We'll put him one above Orochimaru. I think Pain's a better villain in terms of like writing, but Madara is so badass. Oh my god. It's yeah. Nah, it doesn't even need to be discussed, honestly. Shin! Sheen? Is it Shin or Sheen? He's kind of cool. My favorite arc of Boruto so far. Well, no, I guess the Momoshiki one's better. She wasn't too bad. I wouldn't say F tier. Very hopeful individual saying I'm gonna revive the Akatsuki. And he had a cool fight with Sakura and kind of Sasuke. I'm gonna put him in C. I'm gonna put him above Tonari. I'm just gonna do that real quick. Okay, cool. Let's do Zabuza. Chat, I will let you in on a little secret. I cried in original Naruto one time. And you know what scene it was? It was Zabuza holding Haku. That is the one time I cried in original Naruto. I remember because it was the first time I cried at an anime and I called Naomi. I was like, it hurts. And she knew exactly what I was talking about. She's like, I know. I'm like, why is it so sad? They're 2D. He goes to A. I feel like Haku goes a little bit higher because of that too. Yeah, that caught me off guard, dude. That was the first time I cried at anime, I think. I'm pretty sure. So I'll put him at A, I think. Not S, but very, very, very good still. I'm actually gonna, I don't know. I'll put him at top of A, honestly. A lot of development too, lot. Kaguya is an interesting one. Dude, my problem with Kaguya is like, she has so much power. Such immense power, and she spent half of her time resurrected like this. That was literally how she spent her time. J- just chilling, just hanging out, straight vibing. It was only until she realized there was a chance she could lose that she started trying. I swear to God, she lost to sexy harem jutsu. I mean, dude, she should have been able to just one-shot everybody if she wanted to. She wasn't trained for combat. I see a lot of people say that. But when you have that much power, dude, I feel like you don't need to be trained for combat, you know? So what would the story of Naruto have been like if it had gone like this? They're standing there, okay? The infinite Tsukuyomi just went off, right? And they're standing there. They're like confronting Madara, right? And Zetsu doesn't kill Madara. Like, that just doesn't, it doesn't kill Madara. And it's a fight between all of them and Madara. And then they defeat Madara. And then Naruto and Sasuke have their fight. Would Naruto Shippuden be a better show? Yes or no? I feel like that would have even been a more impactful death for Obito to die to Madara, since Madara is the one that saved him and raised him, right? Imagine him dying to Madara's hand then. Any disagreements? I know the author, Kishimoto said he had no idea how to kill off Madara. But I think it could have easily been written a way for Naruto, Sasuke, and Sakura, and Kakashi and Obito to take down Madara, I think. There's Indra and Ashura. Who was the good one? Yes, Ashura was the good one. This is Indra. He was cool. He was like the beginning of like the, you know, the bloodlines going down. Definitely above D. Is he above C? He's either B or C. I think he's better written than Kaguya. And I actually liked his backstory. I'll put him right here. I'll put him right there, I think. Chat, can I get a refresher? Can I get a refresher? Chunin exam villain. Oh yeah, he stops them. Not memorable enough, IMO. Just not memorable enough. Where'd he go? Yeah, not memorable enough. Again, these lower tiers, I'm not even sorting. I know the higher ones I kinda am. These lower ones, the order doesn't even matter. Gaara as a villain, not Gaara as a character. I love Gaara as a character. He's one of the best characters. But Gaara as a villain, there's the scene with him and Rock Lee. As a villain, he was intimidating. Either A or B, for sure. I'm gonna put Gaara in B. As a villain, he's B. As a character, he's either A or S. But as a villain, he's B, I think. He broke Lee's arms and didn't kill him because Guy stopped the fight. This is true. Fine, A. He's going in A. Final decision, A. Okay, low A. Gar's low A villain. Okay, Momoshiki and Kinshiki. I think Momoshiki will go above Kinshiki. I think Kinshiki's character design is cooler. He's a unit, dude. Momoshiki just like straight vibing. Momoshiki brought in the best fight out of both series, dude. I legitimately think Naruto and Sasuke fighting Momoshiki is the coolest fight in OG Naruto, Shippuden, and Boruto. I legitimately think that's the coolest fight. I'm gonna put Momoshiki at a mid A and Kinshiki at a low B. Thoughts, comments, questions, concerns? Jack's on crack, why? The amount of times my emotions have changed during this tier list. I'm sorry. What do we think? Are there any in this list that like you're like, Jack, you're freaking high, brother? Are there any? Drop a comment down below if you're watching on YouTube. Datara became very repetitive. I think he's a really good character. He's sick. But I think the clay became repetitive and what he said and thought became repetitive. And I don't want my opinion, or I don't want this list to be swayed based on like what people say or like how I feel like people react. I found Dattebayo repetitive. I think he's a cool villain and a cool character, but he was a little bit repetitive. He's still above all these other people. Chat, I think this is the list. I think this is it. I think we're good. I'm gonna, Lay gave me the good idea to post it on Twitter, and I'll let you guys post yours too. But I think this is pretty solid. I think this is solid. If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe. I don't have any other outro, so that's it. That's the video. Thanks for watching. It got me stone cold.